Today we have two objectives: identify who Charles Darwin was, and to identify the observations that Darwin made on the HMS Beagle. Charles Darwin lived during the 1800s. He spent a lot of his early childhood trying to figure out what he wanted to be as he grew up. His dad tried to direct him into medicine to be a doctor, and he rebelled from that. And then he went and he was going to be a clergyman, a religious guy, and he kind of rebelled from that. So then he started looking at different species, and he spent 5 years on the HMS Beagle collecting data to support his ideals that regarded evolution. He studied many specimens from past to present as he took his trip around the world on the HMS Beagle, and we're going to take a little bit more of a look at his voyage on the HMS Beagle. So I said that Darwin's voyage on the HMS Beagle lasted about 5 years. The ship was to go basically just do a survey of wherever it sailed upon, and it started in Plymouth up here, went down the Canary Islands, around the tip of South America, over to Australia, back around the southern tip of Africa, to the tip of South America, and then back up to Plymouth. So he spent 5 years collecting data on different species all throughout the world. Because of the evidence of specimens that he collected over his voyage on the HMS Beagle, he started to come up with the idea of evolution, which means that the Earth was changing over time. So Charles Darwin took what he found about the Earth changing over time, and he developed a scientific theory about biological evolution, which is evolution is the process of certain species or life changing over time to fit with the changing of the planet. As he traveled, Darwin noticed three distinctive patterns of biological diversity. Species vary globally from one point of the Earth to a different point. Species vary locally, meaning in one small area, the species are different. And he could see that species changed over time by looking at fossils and comparing them to living organisms. So here's an example of species vary globally. Different yet similar animal species inhabited separated but similar habitats around the globe. Some species are found in only in one place on the planet. We have three land-dwelling birds in three different places around the Earth. More specifically, it's three different continents on Earth. So this is an example of species vary globally. Species vary locally. Different yet related animal species often occupy different habitats within a local area. So we have a small cluster of islands in which the HMS Beagle stopped at. You have Isabella Island and Hood Island, and you can see that within a relatively close distance between the two islands, you could see two major differences in neck lengths between the two tortoises. So this is an example of species vary locally. Species vary over time. Darwin collected fossils, preserved remains, and other traces of dead organisms. And some fossils of the extinct animals were similar to living species. For example, he found the fossil of a glyptodont, which was pretty big. It was a giant rodent, and he realized that the structure is very similar to that of the armadillo, which is significantly smaller, 6 times smaller than the glyptodont. So this is an example of species vary over time. So over this 5-year voyage, Darwin had to put together a lot of pieces to come up with his hypothesis of evolution. So some of the major stops that we're going to talk about, well, the one major stop that we're going to talk about is right off of South America, and that's the Galapagos Islands. So Darwin began to wonder whether different Galapagos species might have evolved from some South American ancestors. So he thought that the islands maybe split off of South America, and because the islands went in different directions, maybe that was a mechanism that caused change in different species. He spent years actively researching and filling up different notebooks with ideas about species and evolution. The evidence suggested that species are not fixed and that they could change by some natural process. So we began today to identify Charles Darwin. I gave you a little bit of background about his different career paths, and I gave you a little bit more of a background of him as a naturalist. We started to identify observations that Darwin made on the HMS Beagle, between the tortoises of Hood and Isabella Island. We talked a little bit about the Galapagos, which we will do further research on the Galapagos Island in another tutorial. If you have any questions about Darwin's voyage on the HMS Beagle, please bring it to class.